In this screencast, we will begin our analysis of an integrating process. An integrating process is a process which is non-self-regulating and will generally converge to a steady state caused by a disturbance to either infinity or negative infinity. Although there are not many processes that are integrating, one very common one, as shown in the example here, is an example of an integrating process. And as we move through this problem, we will discuss why this process is an integrating process and what that means. Here we have a cylindrical tank with liquid height H and cross-section layer A and volumetric flow rates of Q in for the inlet flow rate and Q out for the outlet flow rate. The inlet flow rate is allowed to vary, whereas the outlet flow rate is assumed to be constant. So to begin our analysis, we will use a mass balance, which is accumulation equals in minus out. There is no chemical reaction going on, so that term will be neglected. Since we are doing a mass balance, we have a volumetric flow rate Q in, but that's a volumetric flow rate, not a mass flow rate. So to convert to a mass flow rate, we would use the density rho. Also exiting the system would be that same rho multiplied by Q out. In this analysis, we're assuming that temperature isn't changing, so therefore, the density of the fluid will remain unchanged. So the accumulation will be d mass d time. And the amount of mass of the system will be equal to the volume multiplied by the density. So it'll be the density, rho. And the volume of fluid inside the tank at any given time will be A, the cross-sectional area, times H. Due to the fact that rho and A are constant values, we can factor them out. And it leaves us with our differential equation, our mass balance. As a final step, we can cancel out all the rows. Now that we have our mathematical model, what we'll now do is put the model into deviation variables. Here, we have two variables in this process. Q out here is a constant because of what is stated in the problem statement. So therefore, we'll develop deviation variables, which are defined as H prime, which will equal H, the height at a given time, minus h bar. And we'll do the same thing for q in prime, which will equal q in minus q bar. Now we'll substitute in these deviation variable definitions into our differential equation. Next, we'll evaluate our equation at steady state. When we evaluate at steady state, the left-hand side becomes zero because there was no change in height there. And we'll have q in at its steady state, the bar value, minus q out, which is also at the bar value, but since it's a constant, we'll just leave it as such. When we subtract the steady state from the unsteady state, we have the left-hand side is A, d times h prime plus h bar dt equals the q in bars cancel out, as do the q out terms. So all we're left with on the right-hand side is q in prime. Before we take the Laplace transform of this equation, we take advantage of the fact that h bar is a constant, which means the fact that dh bar dt is zero. So that leaves us with a dh prime dt equals q in prime. So if we take the Laplace transform of this, what we end up with is a times, I'm going to capitalize the h to indicate that's the Laplace variable, so it'll be h prime times s equals q. Add a tilde here just to indicate the fact that it is the Laplace variable and not the variable in the time domain. So one thing that you'll notice from this equation in comparison to most transfer function models is that there is no h term on the right-hand side. And this is something that is indicative of an integrating process, because an integrating process does not have any process feedback. So the terms on the right-hand side act as an internal feedback regulating system for the process. But here, that does not exist. So if we develop our transfer function relating the height of the tank to the inlet flow rate of the tank, we end up with 1 over AS. The important point to note here is the fact that this is, again, the lack of a plus 1 in the denominator also is a good sign of an integrating process. Generally, most processes we have a denominator that of tau s plus 1 or tau squared s squared plus 2 zeta. Important part is there's always some constant there. But here, we do not see that. Now that we have found the transfer function, we can answer part B, which asks us to take a look at what the effect would be of a step change of magnitude m in the inlet flow rate. Since we have a transfer function in the Laplace domain, we need to evaluate this step change in the Laplace domain. So recall the fact that a step change in the Laplace domain is equal to m over s, where m is the magnitude of the step. So when we look at this, we can substitute that into our function. So where we see q in, we'll replace that with m over s, and that will equal 1 over as. When we isolate this, we have the fact that h prime equals m over a times 1 over s squared. The inverse Laplace transform of this can be taken quite easily. So the inverse Laplace transform of h prime will be h. And the inverse Laplace transform of 1 over s squared is t. So therefore, our final answer here is m over a multiplied by t. By looking at this equation, we see the fact that the height of fluid inside the tank is a linear function. So what this means is the fact that as time goes on, this height is going to become higher and higher and higher. As t approaches infinity, h will approach either positive or negative infinity, which is depending on if m is a positive or negative number. So h will approach positive infinity when the step function is positive, and will approach negative infinity when m is a negative number. In other words, the step decreases. So if we think about this for a second, this makes sense, because if we think about a bathtub, for example, if the plunger is out, the water will go at a generally constant rate. So if the water coming out of the faucet is at a perfect match with the water exiting, it'll remain constant. Whereas if there's too much water coming in, your system would overflow. In other words, your height would approach positive infinity. Whereas if you have too little water going into the bathtub, the height of the water in the tub will decrease until it empties, which is the practical application of h heading towards negative infinity. The reason why this happens is because there is, for an integrating process, there is no process feedback. This system operates regardless of the height of the tank. It's not an effect. Important point from this analysis is that no process feedback means the fact that this process cannot regulate itself, which can lead to instability.